Well, it's been compared to thrillers written by Brad Thor, Daniel Silva, and even Tom Clancy. And of course, we're talking about the Gray Man series from best-selling author and Memphis native Mark Greaney.
And Mission Critical is the latest installment in that very popular series. It hits bookshelves tomorrow. I've been reading it, and I'm telling you, it's awesome. So we're so happy to have Mark back in our studio.
Thanks for having me back.
And we should mention, too, you wrote how many, eight Tom Clancy novels?
I wrote seven. I wrote three with Tom before he passed away. And then the family hired me to continue the series, so I did four more after that.
Yeah, there are still people clamoring for you to go back to that, but you had to give that one up so you could devote some more time to court.
Yeah, there was enough other things to do that I felt like it was time to let somebody fresh come in and take over that mantle.
Yeah. So tell us what Court Gentry is up to now.
Well, this is book eight, and they're all standalone, so you don't have to read them in order. That would be terrible. terrible to ask someone to do that.
Yeah, terrible to ask. It's not terrible to
It's not terrible to read them, but this one has, it's sort of two plot lines. Court's love interest is a Russian named Zoya, and she's been flipped by the CIA. She finds out some information about the death of her father, and that sends her off to Europe to look for answers. And at the same time, Court is on a CIA transport plane where a prisoner is kidnapped, and he goes off in pursuit of him, which sends him sort of into the same area, into London and up into Scotland. And so their two storylines kind of dovetail, and they each have sort of a secret that the other one needs to fix it up.
And
we finally took the words.
I haven't gotten to where I find out the secret. Okay, go ahead.
Look, you can't get all the answers.
Yeah, right? I know.
So you can come in fresh to start just reading this book. Like, how do you keep it flowing? You know, like over the course.
You know, I like to make every book different in some way. So I think a lot about that because I'm a reader first and foremost, and a writer second. And I think about reading books and feel like, wow, they're kind of rehashing something they've done before or something. So each book has to feel really, really different to me. So if I always go back to that mantra, then I'll do things I haven't done before, and it does keep it fresh. I mean, it's harder every year because you keep telling the stories that you know, and you tell the stories that you just figure out, and you tell the stories that you dig out of the earth, and then it just gets tougher and tougher. But I still have plots, so I'm okay.
Yeah, and they're international thrillers, so you do have a big, big world to explore. Yeah. Are you already thinking of where you want to go next? Because one thing that maybe you don't know is that you go to these places. Mm-hmm. You kind of embed yourself.
Yeah, I spent a bit of time in Scotland and in England for this book. But yeah, the next book is already on the drawing board, and I'm going to go to Croatia and Spain and LA for that in the spring. And then I just did a deal for three more books. So I'll have to figure out. I want to do one in Japan because I just want to go to Japan.
Yeah.
I'll find a story there. But yeah, so that might be the next one.
And you've had best-selling books. Do you have it in your mind that you want to top the one previously, or is that a goal?
I want to write them better. I always want to become a better writer, and I feel like from book one to book eight, I've grown a lot. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't have to be a bigger story or anything like that. My sales are going really well, and each book's doing better than the last, and I just want to keep executing what people want to read, and don't think about making a bigger story, but just better writing.
Right. So we always ask you, because you've had a movie deal with several different entities
for 10
on the
years.
Table.
This is my 10th year, and I had a movie deal in 2009.
Yeah. So I know you're tired of us asking you, but when, because this series would make such a great series of movies.
There's different studios have had it over the years, different directors have been attached, and nothing ever worked out, but Sony owns the rights to it now, and they have a new director, and they wrote a new screen or had a new screenplay commission, which I read in November or December or something like that. Yeah. So it seems like every year I've got some sort of positive idea, and it doesn't really come through. I have some friends who are authors whose first movie came out from their first book 15-18 years after the book came out, so I feel like I might be on track for that because we're at year 10.
Well, we can't wait because it will be great. A great, great movie.
I appreciate it.
Congrats to you.
Thank you so much.
That's good.
All right, so book signing this weekend. He's setting out on a national tour, so when you see him on Saturday, you can ask him how Washington was in Arizona.
All of it.
All that. All right. Thanks, Mark.
Thank
Good
you so
to
much.
See you
Appreciate
as
it.
Always.
Thank you.